Hello viewers, how are you? Welcome to my channel Physics with Rams. So today we are going to discuss about energy in SHM, simple harmonic motion. Before going to start this topic, let us revise what we had discussed in the case of oscillations. In the previous chapters, we had discussed what is meant by circular motion, as well as what is meant by periodic motion, as well as we had discussed about what is meant by oscillations. And we had represented what is meant by simple harmonic motion when we consider this simple harmonic motion. As well as we had derived the displacement equation as x is equals to a sine omega t plus pi, whereas velocity has been represented as v is equals to a omega cos omega t plus pi, whereas the acceleration is given as a is equals to a omega square minus a omega square sine omega t plus pi. So here, as you observe that here the displacement is represented as x is equals to a sine omega t plus pi. If you substitute this value here, we have a small a is equals to minus omega square into x. Based on that, here we had represented that acceleration is directly proportional to displacement in opposite direction. Whereas in this case, the force is represented as f is equals to minus kx, so based on that here we can represent that force is directly proportional to minus x. The force acting in the case of SHM is directly proportional to displacement in opposite direction. Then we can consider this force as a conservative. One more equation for velocity is, we know that v is equal to omega into under root of a square minus x square, which we had derived. Now, as we consider this energy in SHM, we can represent that this energy can be split up into two types. One is potential energy, as well as second one is kinetic energy. Mechanical energy can be represented as potential energy and kinetic energy. So in this case, we consider kinetic energy when the body is in motion. When the body is in moving position, means when the body is oscillating, then we can represent this kinetic energy. Whereas since the force is conserved and it attains a particular height in the case of oscillations, we can represent that this SHM possesses potential energy. Because the body will attain a particular height from the ground like this. Again it reaches to this position, it lifts up to a particular height, again it reaches. So based on that, here we can represent this potential energy. We are going to derive the expression for kinetic energy. We know that kinetic energy is given as k is equals to half mv square, where v is equals to omega into under root of a square minus x square. As we substitute this value in this equation, here we get k is equals to half m into omega square into a square minus x square. So this represents a kinetic energy equation, whereas here m omega square can be represented as k. K is equals to m omega square. In this case, we can represent the kinetic energy as half k into a square minus x square. So here, as we consider oscillation at a mean position, here displacement will be equal to 0. Why? Because here we consider it as origin. And at extreme position, displacement is being represented by amplitude, x is equals to a at both ends. So now based on that, here we are going to represent the kinetic energy at mean position as well as at extreme positions. So at mean position, the kinetic energy is represented as k is equals to half into m omega square into a square minus 0 square. Nothing but here we get a kinetic energy as a half m omega square into a square.
at mean position.
So here, based on that, we can represent that the kinetic energy at a mean position will be maximum.
At mean position, kinetic energy is a maximum.
Now we are going to discuss the kinetic energy at a extreme position. Here, observe that at extreme position, x is equals to displacement x is equals to a. As we substitute this value here, we have k is equals to half m omega square into a square minus a square. So here we get a zero. At extreme position, kinetic energy is equals to zero, or we can also represent it as minimum. Minimum value of a kinetic energy. Observe that here we had represented the expression for kinetic energy, as well as we had represented the maximum kinetic energy as well as the minimum kinetic energy. Now we are going to represent the expression for kinetic energy with respect to time. Kinetic energy and time. Observe that here the kinetic energy is represented as half mv square, where v is equals to a omega cos of omega t plus phi. Then kinetic energy is given as half m a square omega square cos square omega t plus phi. This represents the expression for kinetic energy in terms of time. Take a screenshot, we will continue. Now we are going to derive the expression for potential energy in terms of SHM. Whereas in order to derive this, we consider the conservative force equation, and we know that F is equals to minus kx. Since the force is conservative, here the work done is represented as dW is equals to F into dx. F into dx. As we integrate this equation, then we can represent it as integration of dW is equals to minus of integration of F into dx. F into dx. Whereas here observe that F is equals to minus kx. As we substitute this value in this equation, here we get an integration of dW is equals to minus of minus plus kx into dx. Kx into dx, where k is constant. K is a constant. And here we know that integration of x to the power of n into dx is equals to x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. N plus 1 by n plus 1. So here we have to represent the limits for this work done as well as this displacement. Here the displacement has been changed from 0 to x, from mean position to extreme position. And here the potential energy at the mean position is represented as u naught, and potential energy at the extreme position is represented as u. So here observe that integration of dW is nothing but W, work done W within the limits u naught to u is equals to, where k is constant, x into dx. Here the power of x is 1. As we consider it as n, here 1 plus 1, nothing but 2, x to the power of 2 by 2. So here we get a k into x square by 2 within the limits 0 to x. 0 to x. As we substitute the limits here, we get a u minus u naught is equals to half k x square. Already we had discussed that k is a constant, and it is represented as m omega square. So if we substitute this value here, we get a u is equals to u naught plus half m omega square x square. Whereas initial potential energy is represented as 0. Why? Because it will be at the lowest position. So here u naught is considered as 0. As we substitute this value here, we get u is equals to half m omega square x square. So this represents the expression for potential energy. Let us represent the maximum and minimum potential energy at mean position as well as extreme position. At mean position, we know that x is equals to 0. at extreme position, we know that x is equals to E. So based on that, the potential energy at main position is given as half m into omega square into zero square. So here we get a zero. Based on that, we can represent a potential energy at mean position is zero, or we can also consider it as a minimum value of potential energy. Whereas at extreme position, the displacement is represented as x equals to a. As we substitute this value here, we get u is equals to half m omega square a square. So based on this expression, we can represent that the potential energy will be maximum at a extreme position. At a extreme position. Take a screenshot, we will continue. Now we are going to represent the expression for total energy, and here we know that the total energy is given as the sum of potential energy plus kinetic energy. Here, as you observe that at mean position, kinetic energy is maximum, whereas potential energy is minimum. Potential energy is minimum, whereas at extreme position, kinetic energy is a minimum, potential energy is a maximum, as well as at this extreme position. Here observe that kinetic energy is a minimum, potential energy is a maximum. Based on that, here we can represent that potential energy is a variable. It varies from extreme position to mean position, as well as from mean position to extreme position. From minimum to maximum, maximum to minimum. So we can consider it as a variable. Whereas as we consider kinetic energy, after that at mean position it is maximum, as we move towards extreme position it is a minimum, as well as we move towards this extreme position, here the kinetic energy is minimum. So after that, it is changing from minimum to maximum, maximum to minimum. So we here also we can consider it as a variable. Whereas the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy results to conservative. Why? Because here the total energy remains constant. It does not vary from one position to another position, either from mean position to extreme position or extreme position to mean position. Let us represent this expression. Observe that here the potential energy is given as P is equal to half m omega square ax square. Whereas kinetic energy is given as half m omega square into a square minus x. As we substitute these two values in this expression, here we get half m omega square x square plus half m omega square into a square minus x square. So if you take half m omega square as common, here we get half m omega square into x square plus a square minus x square. So here we get half m omega square into a square. So this represents the total energy which is present at any position. So let us see the total energy at mean position. Observe that here kinetic energy is given as half m omega square into a square, whereas the potential energy at mean position is zero, u is equal to zero. So as we represent the total energy here, we get zero plus half m omega square a square, which is nothing but it is equal to half m omega square into a square. Observe that it is a constant. Whereas when we consider the total energy at extreme position, observe that here the potential energy is maximum at extreme position, and it is represented as half m omega square a square, whereas the kinetic energy at extreme position is zero. As we substitute this value here, we get a total energy as a half m omega square a square.
Observe that here the total energy is half m omega square a square at extreme position, as well as it is half m omega square a square at mean position. Based on that, here we can represent that the total energy is conservative. It is conservative. It does not vary from one position to another position. Take a screenshot. We will continue. Now we are going to solve a numerical based on this total energy, mechanical energy. Observe that a linear harmonic oscillator of force constant 2 into 10 to the power of 6 newton per meter and amplitude of 0.101 meter has a total mechanical energy of 160 joule. Then find maximum and minimum values of potential and kinetic energy. So here observe that the force constant is given as a k is equals to 2 into 10 to the power of 6 newton per meter, as well as the amplitude is given as 0.01 meter. The total energy is given as E is equals to 160 joule. As we had seen that kinetic energy will be maximum. Kinetic energy will be maximum at mean position, and kinetic energy is a minimum at extreme positions. At extreme positions, whereas a potential energy is maximum at extreme positions, whereas it is minimum at mean position. Potential energy is a minimum at a mean position. So based on this, now we have to represent the expressions for maximum and minimum values of potential and kinetic energy. Whereas here the potential energy is represented as U equals to U naught plus half k x square. So if x is equals to 0, here we get U is equals to U naught, whereas the kinetic energy expression is given as k is equals to half m or half k into a square minus x square. Let us find out maximum kinetic energy, whereas maximum kinetic energy is represented as k suffix max, which is equals to half m omega square a square. Here in the place of omega, m omega square, we consider k into a square, where the value of k is 2 into 10 to the power of 6 and the value of a is 0.01. as we substitute these values, here we have 2 into 10 to the power of 6 into a square 10 to the power of minus 2 whole square. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled, and here observe that 10 to the power of 6 into 10 to the power of minus 4. So since bases are same, powers are added, 6 minus 4 nothing but 2, nothing but 10 square is nothing but 100 joule. Maximum kinetic energy is 100 joule at mean position, whereas we know that the kinetic energy will be zero or minimum at extreme positions. At extreme position, the kinetic energy is equals to 0. Now we have to represent the expression for potential energy, minimum potential energy. When the kinetic energy is maximum, potential energy will be minimum. Then based on the expression of mechanical energy, we know that total energy is equals to potential energy plus kinetic energy. So we can consider it as potential energy minimum is equals to total energy minus kinetic energy maximum kinetic energy. Here observe that the total energy is 160 joule, 160 minus 100, which is nothing but 60 joule. So minimum potential energy is 60 joule at mean position. The maximum potential energy is represented as the total energy minus minimum kinetic energy. Here the minimum kinetic energy is 0 joule. So as we substitute here, we have 160 minus 0. So here we get 160 joule. maximum potential energy is 160 joule and minimum potential energy is 60 joule. Take a screenshot, we will continue. Now we are going to solve another numerical based on this total energy. After that, a particle of mass 1 kg is executing SHM with an amplitude of 1 meter and a time period pi seconds. Calculate the kinetic energy of the particle at the moment when the displacement is 0.8 meter from mean position. So here a body is oscillating from mean position to extreme position, whereas the amplitude is 1 meter. Now we have to find the kinetic energy when the displacement is 0.8 meter. So here we know that the expression for kinetic energy is given as half m into v square, where v is equals to omega into under root of a square minus x square, a square minus x square. Require the value of omega a as well as x. Here x is given as 0.8 meter and a is given as 1 meter, where we require the value of omega, where omega is equal to 2 pi by t. Here we know the value of t as a pi seconds, the time period as a pi second. As we substitute this value here, we have 2 pi by pi. Pi and pi gets cancelled and we get omega equals to 2 radian per second. So as we substitute these values in this expression, here we get the linear velocity as v is equals to 2 into under root of 1 square minus 0.8 square. So after that 2 into 1 minus 0.64. 0.64 can be represented as 0.36. We get a 2 into 0.36 can be represented as 0.6. 2 into 0.6 is nothing but 1.2 meter per second. V is equals to 1.2 meter per second. Then kinetic energy can be given as K is equals to half into mass is 1 kg into velocity square 1.2 whole square. Then we can represent it as 1/2 into 1.44. As we cancel here, we have 7 to the 14 and 2 to the 4, we get a 0.72 joule. 0.72 joule. This represents the expression for kinetic energy. Take a screenshot, we will continue. The next problem is the potential energy of a harmonic oscillator of mass 2 kg in its mean position is 5 joule. If its total energy is 9 joule and its amplitude is 0.01 meter, find its time period. Here observe that the potential energy is given as 5 joule and mass is 2 kg. Mass is 2 kg. And the total energy at mean position is 9 joule and amplitude is 0.01 meter. Now we have to represent a time period. Come to the case, we know that a total energy is equals to kinetic energy plus potential energy. Kinetic energy plus potential energy, where kinetic energy is given as total energy minus potential energy. Here total energy is 9 joule, whereas the potential energy is 5 joule. So as we substitute here, we get 9 minus 5 is equal to 4 joule at mean position. 4 joule at a mean position. Whereas at mean position, kinetic energy is represented as half m omega square a square. Or we can also represent it as half k a square. From this expression, here we have to find the value of force constant K, whereas K is equals to 2 into kinetic energy by amplitude square. Here kinetic energy is 4 by amplitude is 10 to the power of minus 2 whole square. because 0.01 can be represented as a 10 to the power of a minus 2 meter. So here observe that 2 into 4 is 8. As we bring this 10 to the power of minus 4 towards numerator, it becomes plus 8 into 10 to the power of 4 newton per meter. So this represents a force constant K. By using this expression, we have to represent a time period. Whereas the time period is given as t is equals to 2 pi into under root of m by k. Here 2 pi into the value of m is 2 by k is 8 into 10 to the power of 4. Observe that 2 4s are 8. So as we apply square root to the for this 1 by 4 into 10 to the power of 4, here we get 2 pi by 2 into 10 to the power of 2. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled, here we have pi into 10 to the power of minus 2 seconds. So this represents the expression for time period. Take a screenshot, we will continue. The next problem is, observe that the displacement of two identical particles executing as HM are represented by expressions x1 is equal 4 sin 10 t plus pi by 6 and x2 is equal to 5 cos omega t. For what values of this omega, energy of both the particles is same. Here we are representing that the total energy of the both the particles is the same. And here these two particles are identical. Based on that we can represent m1 is equal to m2. Mass of both the particles is same. Whereas the total energy is given as E is equal to half m omega square into a square. Since mass is constant for both the particles, we can represent that energy is directly proportional to a omega whole square. As the energy is same, we can represent a1 omega 1 whole square is equal to a2 omega 2 whole square, where the value of omega 1 has to be derived from this expression by comparing the equation with x is equal to a sin omega t plus pi. So as we compare this expression with this expression, here we get a1 is equal to 4 and omega 1 is equal to 10. Why? Because omega t is equal to 10 t. So here we get omega 1 equals to 10 and pi is equal to pi by 6. Now similarly, as we compare this expression with the second expression, here observe that amplitude a2 is equal to 5 and pi is equal to pi by 2. Why? Because it is in terms of cos. Whereas here we had comparing this equation with sin, 90 minus theta or 90 plus theta, we can consider both. So pi is represented as a pi by 2. Whereas here we have to represent the value of omega 2 as omega. Now as we substitute these expressions in this equation, here we get a 10 into a1 is 4 whole square is equal to a2 is 5 into omega whole square. As we apply square root on both sides, here we get 40 is equal to 5 omega. Omega is equal to 40 by 5, nothing but 8, because 5 8 is 40 radian per second. Take a screenshot. I hope that you had enjoyed my video. Please give a like to this video, share this video to your friends, and don't forget to subscribe my channel.